How to do the first startup of the compressor. We need manometer unit, whips for refrigerant charging, thermal imaging camera, temperature probe, pressure probe, vacuum gauge, appropriate wrench for the opening of the suction and discharge valve, fittings required to create the vacuum in the compressor, a 14mm socket wrench, Teflon sealant paste, leak detector, a cylinder with refrigerant gas, and a vacuum pump. Advice: to maintain a good vacuum threshold, we recommend using pressure taps with a shredder valve and a vacuum valve with shredder pressure. We also need safety helmet, safety goggles, safety gloves, safety shoes. Attention! Keep and read the instructions manual carefully and always respect the safety warnings indicated. How to vacuum the compressor and the system at first startup. If the circuit is under nitrogen pressure, discharge it into the atmosphere up to atmospheric pressure. Connect a sufficient number of hoses to effectively reach every point of the refrigerant circuit. All valves must be open. Open the suction and discharge valve with a suitable wrench. Remove the NPT plug and insert the pressure control valve. Remove the cap and connect a whip connector from the vacuum pump to the compressor. Apply the Teflon sealing paste on the first threads of the pressure control valve fitting. Put on the pressure tap, replacing the NPT plug removed previously. Connect all the whip connectors to a single manifold that is connected to a two-stage vacuum pump. Carry out maximum vacuum following the provisions of the EN3782 standard. Open the valves connected to the vacuum pump whip connectors previously positioned and turn on the vacuum pump. Advice: reach a vacuum level of 20 Pascal for a time not less than that necessary for the heater or crankcase heater to bring the oil to a temperature of at least 20 Kelvin higher than the ambient temperature. If the pump reaches the expected vacuum value in a shorter time, keep it running until the recommended oil temperature is reached. With the pump stopped, the vacuum must be maintained within more or less 20% of the value obtained with the pump running. If it does not happen, repeat the evacuation operation or recheck the entire refrigeration circuit for any leak. Once the vacuum is reached, turn off the pump and close the vacuum pump valves. Remove the whip connectors and screw the pressure control valve back on. How to charge the refrigerant gas? Check that all the solenoids are not powered. Connect the hoses of the manifold to a low pressure and a high pressure connection on the line between the condenser and the thermostat. Attention! Never connect the manometer unit to the discharge. Charge liquid refrigerant gas coming exclusively from cylinders with an intact guarantee seal, only in the liquid refrigerant line, possibly in the liquid receiver. Attention! Never charge liquid refrigerant in the suction line. When the liquid refrigerant stops flowing into the liquid receiver, close the valves of the manometer unit or whip connector. Then charge the gas in the vapor phase into the rest of the refrigerant circuit, including the compressor. For the entire duration of the charging operation, keep the oil heaters on. Check that the oil does not change color, density or appearance, and it does not form foams. If this happens, it means that it has come into contact with the liquid refrigerant gas. Repeat the operation from the beginning. At this point, the refrigerant charge contained in the circuit is sufficient for starting the compressor. How to finish startup? Continue the refrigerant charge until the desired charge is reached, adding refrigerant gas in small doses. Ensure to keep the discharge temperature about 30 Kelvin above the condensing temperature. Wait 1 minute for the parameters to stabilize every 5 minutes of charging. Keep the oil level under control. If it falls below the minimum level, more refrigerant may need to be added. In this case, stop the compressor, close the valves, recover the gas contained in the compressor, and pour the oil into the appropriate inlet. At the end of the topping up operation, vacuum the compressor and reopen the valves. Attention! Do not add oil anywhere else in the refrigeration circuit, except in the oil separators, if available. If the topping up operation requires to be performed several times, maybe there's an obstruction or an incorrectly sized siphon. Attention! The oil level must never exceed 3/4 of the oil sight glass. The compressor must never operate with an excessive oil charge to avoid the breaking of the valves and a sudden and violent oil return. Attention! The maximum number of compressor starts must be 6 per hour, and the minimum operating time must be 5 minutes. Advice: perform the measurements and store them in the machine log. Measurements must contain at least liquid temperature, suction temperature, air temperature, evaporating pressure, condensing temperature, discharge temperature, oil temperature, current on all phases, line voltages on all phases. If you like this video, subscribe to the channel and discover all Frascold's video trainings. Frascold, blue is better.